Let's look at how simple it is to create an entity relationship diagram using Oracle SQL Data Modeler. You'll need to have Oracle SQL Data Modeler installed. If you have a Mac and want to install Oracle SQL Data Modeler, there's a link here, and there's a link in the description below on how to install it on Mac. To install on Windows, open your browser and in Google type Oracle SQL Data Modeler Download, which is this link. I've given the download link in the description below. For Windows, there are two options. If you have Java installed on your system, you can choose Windows 32-bit/64-bit. But note that you may have to give the path to the Java .exe file. If you're not confident about setting the path to the Java .exe file, or you don't have Java installed on your system, select the second option, the Windows 64-bit with JDK included. Once you've made your selection, you'll be taken to a page that asks you to log in. You should have an Oracle account. Log in, and the download will start automatically. Once downloaded, unzip the contents into your C drive. Create a shortcut on your desktop to the Data Modeler .exe, which is in the Data Modeler folder in the C drive. Right-click anywhere on your desktop and select New, Shortcut. Then make your way to the Data Modeler .exe. Double-click on the shortcut you created for the Data Modeler to open the Oracle SQL Data Modeler application. Right-click on Untitled Design and select Close Design. This will open a new design, and you will see two tabs in the left pane, Logical and Relational. We will not work in the relational part. We will work in the logical part to create our ERDs. We can also generate a script afterwards to create a database based on the ERD we have created. Let's create an ERD of a simple library scenario. Our book entity will be named book and not books. In data modeling, we don't use the plural, so we create our entities with the name of book, not books. The attributes we have for book are the ISBN, which is unique for each book, and we will use this as the primary key. We will also have as attributes the book name and the date the book was published. Now, you could think of many more attributes, but I won't be adding other attributes to keep this demo short. Our user entity has the attributes user ID and first name. Now, we have a many-to-many relationship, which we need to break by using a joining entity. With the link entity, our ERD looks like this. The library holds copies of books. Each copy is of a single book, and a given book has one or more copies. For example, there would be more copies of Harry Potter than Advanced Calculus. Library users may borrow copies of books. Each copy is borrowed out to at most one user. For relationship modality, a user doesn't have to borrow a book, and a book doesn't have to be borrowed. This is what we will implement for our ERD. Here's the data dictionary that we will use. It shows the attributes and their data type. We can see on the Oracle SQL Data Modeler interface that we have a selection of tools at the top. We will use the entity tool to draw out the book entity. Click on it to enter the name of the entity. We can add the attributes of our entity. Go to the attributes and click on the plus sign. Then, under attribute properties, add the attribute's name, ISBN. To add the attribute data type, notice by default, domain is selected. I can pick different options. I'll choose logical. And from the drop-down list, I'll select varchar for ISBN. From the data dictionary, this has a size of 20 characters. As this is our primary key, select primary UID, then click apply. Next, we'll add the book name. The data type is varchar, and its size is 10, which means the name can have 10 characters. We have to select mandatory, as we need the name, it cannot be null. Finally, we'll add the date the book was published. The data type we will use is the Oracle date. Here we'll not select mandatory, which means the value can be null. Click OK. We can see the pound sign next to the ISBN, which indicates that this is the primary key. The asterisk indicates the attribute value is mandatory. The O next to the attribute date indicates that the value is optional. I'll do the subsequent two entities quickly following the same procedure. Now we come to relationships. The book and user entities have a many-to-many relationship as users can borrow many books and books can have many users. We need to break this many-to-many relationship. To break it, we have a joining entity copy, so that each user can borrow many copies but each copy is borrowed by one user. We also have each book can have many copies and each copy is for a single book. Select New MN Relation, click anywhere on book and then click anywhere on copy. This will open up a dialog box. Enter the relation description in name on source, in our case, has. So a book has a copy. Then do the same for name on target, is a copy is a book. Next, select source to target cardinality, which should be set to many. The asterisk stands for many. Check target to source cardinality is set to 1. Next, ensure that source optional and the target optional are unchecked, making the relationship mandatory. I'll repeat this with the user and copy entities. Select source to target cardinality, which should be set to many. The asterisk stands for many. Check target to source cardinality is set to 1. Next, ensure that source optional and the target optional are checked, making the relationship optional. You'll notice that I haven't added any foreign keys, but in just a moment, we will convert our logical model into a relational model. You'll see a foreign key added to entities that have the crow's foot. Since the crow's foot is here, the foreign key will be added to this entity. First, we need to save our model. Click on File, click on Save. Give your model a meaningful name and save it to a location where you keep your models. You'll notice that the model name will now appear. To create the relational model, click on the Engineer to a Relational Model button, which has the double arrows. Leave everything checked on the logical model and click on Engineer. The Relational Model tab opens up. We can see that the foreign keys have been added in the copy entity. To generate the data definition language script, click the Generate DDL button. From the DDL file editor, you can select your database from here. Click on Generate. This opens the DDL generation options. If you need to make any changes, you do it from here. In our case, no changes are needed. Click OK. Here is our DDL script that we can use to create our database. To save the file, click on Save. I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comments below. So, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to be alerted for more new videos.